episode 2324, From Reject to Rockstar.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people. Happy day. You know what I'm going to say? It is Fry. Yay! And you made it once again. Praise the Lord. We are on the other side. The weekend is here, and guess what? So is Memorial Weekend. I know we're just a few blinks away, but we got to start celebrating now. We've got to start preparing that summer is here. Maybe, just maybe, there's an extra hope. Well, guess what? It's Confessions of an Upset Mama, From Reject to Rockstar. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, I am so excited today. This episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. But I got to tell you, have you ever wondered what it's like to sit there and not love who you are? Our children are experiencing that every day. Is every day ordinary for your child? Confidence is built from life experiences, including successes and failures. How do you go from reject to rockstar? One of the most challenging skills or beliefs to teach is confidence. We're not born with it. Now, we can have some personality traits that lead to that, but that feeling of, I got this, it's always in question. And the question of, gosh, do I really have this, can keep you up through the night into the wee hours of the morning going, gosh, how do I give this blessing of confidence to my child? Maybe you have a child who's graduating this year and you're thinking, oh my gosh, like they're going to spread their wings and fly and I can't be there anymore to catch them. It's scary. I know. Finally, we have now four that are either in or have been through college and graduated. Two completely graduated. One is on the way. The fourth is up and coming. And then we have one little baby left. And he will officially be a junior mid next week. But it's hard to teach them how awesome that they are, to build that confidence. And unfortunately, a lot of our kids are walking around feeling like they are rejects and not rock stars. Our younger generations face some hard times when it comes to confidence, as everything they do is on a stage. And I thought, what better way to title this episode, Reject to Rockstar? Because a lot of them are aiming to be that rock star, but the problem is they're doing it wrong. And they're doing it for the wrong reasons. The stage they show up every day on social media, you know it. Videos, whether that's YouTube, TikTok, you've got grades. Have you noticed how competitive school is nowadays? I mean, it was competitive when I was growing up, but oh my goodness, nothing like it is now. Gaming, you always want to win. And now it's not just about winning, but you get all these bonus points that open up these bank accounts that allow you to go and buy things, that allow you to get to different places in the game. And you're like, I want to go there and I want to be there before my friend gets there. It's very competitive, just like sports. It's not any longer about a fun baseball neighborhood game. Oh no, it's travel ball. It's all out. I've got to be on the best team and I've got to be the best player on the best team. And then you've got dance and cheerleading and gymnastics and you name it, you're there. Believe it or not, there is no more competition to succeed and be number one than there's ever been in centuries before. That's the now that we're living in. That is what we're doing and how we as parents, we are falling into this stuff, the lake of, okay, are they going to be able to get out and achieve? Can they climb that mountaintop? Or are they only going to get, you know, a couple blocks into the mountain before they say, I'm done, I quit? Days can lead into weeks where all the kiddos think about are positioning themselves for success. And there is no way they can escape it because it's in their face all day long. You know what it's like. You get on your social media feed. You scroll through Instagram. I know. I watch my children do it. I watch my husband do it. That's why I don't do it. I'm very careful about why I'm on social media. Because I have the reverse problem. I want to help people out there. And so I begin to immerse myself in other people's lives and I want to answer their questions. And then the next thing you know, it's 2 hours, 3 hours later, and I'm still hanging out. Well, that's not accomplishing what I need to do in my day. And with children, they don't have a reserve button. It's hard for them to push stop because it's addictive. Social media is addictive. Now, I know that's for another episode, so I'm not going to dive deep into that right now. But we need to understand what our children are facing. And as we begin to move into summer, I really want you to consider how you can build your child's confidence. And this is for any age. It can be for your older children. You can still build their confidence. It can be for your 2-year-olds, your 3-year-olds. And everything in between. In order to go from reject to rock star, brighten and build the day with many accomplishments. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Build your child's day with many accomplishments. It's all about the mini. M-I-N-I. I know you were thinking I meant lots of. Mini as in M-A-N-Y, but no. It's not about lots, but in the small. One step at a time leads to miles of greatness. So what are these mini accomplishments? M, master what matters. This is where you can guide your child along the route of his own decisions. What is right for them? You know I have 5 children. We have had to raise each child individually. Now, did we copycat some of the stuff we did with the first, the second, the third, and the fourth with the fifth? Of course we did. But do you know that each one of them have totally different personalities? They each learn differently. They each interact with people differently. Their health is made up differently. They have the same mommy and daddy, but they all came out different, uniquely themselves. And so it's important as parents, as caregivers, as mentors, as coaches, as consultants in their lives to help them master what matters to them, not to their friends, not to us, not to a neighbor, but mastering what matters to them. Number 2, I, ignite the opportunities. Help your child see what is possible, the opportunities that lay before them. Even in failure, there's a silver lining. And I'm here to tell you, our children will fail more than they will succeed. And that's one reason why I wanted to do the Kiss about the mini accomplishments, because most of our kids are aiming for the mini, lots of accomplishments, not the mini as in small accomplishments. The baby steps. We've got to help them see that with failure comes success. That means you're learning. You're learning what didn't work, and you're also learning what did work. There are so many opportunities out there, but that focus of the glass half full takes practice. And you, mom, you have to instill that in your child. Master what matters. Ignite the opportunities. Number 3, N, nurture his interest or her interests. This is where you give them space to learn and grow. Experience new activities and interests, right? As they learn new things, this builds your child up. This says, look, you got what it takes. My children, last night, they were working on a chemistry problem. And I've taken all the sciences too many decades ago. And so I sit there and say, okay, I probably could figure this out, but right now my brain is a little bit slower in that area. So use your siblings and help them. So they're all in there trying to help each other out, figuring out what this problem is. How can we get there? And it was funny because it was getting loud and they were getting boisterous and they were just diving in, trying to learn something new. And I'm like, keep going. Keep trying to find the answer. You'll get there. Now, this is me talking silently in my head. I'm not going to tell them the stories. I wanted them to figure it out. I wanted them to experience, oh my gosh, I've got a problem here, but I can solve the problem. It may not come in 10 seconds. It may take me 2 days, but guess what? We can do it. I can do it. Learning new things expands the mind. It also expands the heart. So nurture your child's interest. And finally, number four, I immerse in his or her own presence. Sometimes we can fast forward to what we wish was happening, which can compromise the needed presence in our everyday. Your child needs to be present. And I'm here to tell you most of the time, they are not. They're used to scrolling through things. This is how they were raised. I know because I'm looking at my children that were raised in a generation without electronics. To now, they are immersing themselves in electronics now that they're older. And for those that have the younger children right now, I'm sitting here going, I'm on my knees praying for you because that's a big challenge. They have a hard choice to make, and that is to be okay with where they are right now. Encourage your child to be present and settled in real time. Not in their success, not in the rewards they reap after even a failure. You know, everybody gets a trophy. You know what I'm talking about. No, not everybody gets a trophy. I'm sorry, they don't. That's a hard knocks life. But if your child can gain confidence from not everybody getting a trophy, then that, my friend, is awesomeness. But unfortunately, we're trying to make everything be equal across the board. And as I told you before, I have 5 children and none of them are equal across the board. Not one of them. And my husband calls 2 of the 5 twins, even though they are the furthest apart from each other via age. But it's funny. They have some characteristics, but really, in reality, no. They are not the same at all. The many accomplishments. Master what matters. Ignite the opportunities. Nurture their interests and immerse themselves in their own presence. These many accomplishments can help your child love himself right where he is. It can help your daughter love herself right where she is. So don't look at, oh my gosh, I've got to build up my child and build their confidence by, oh my gosh, you're awesome. There are going to be days that they aren't awesome. They're going to be fussy. And they're going to make poor decisions. But if they can wrap their head around what's going on, and they can have the confidence of saying, you know what? It's okay if I fell. It's okay that I didn't make it. It's okay that I got to the mountaintop faster than I had prepared. Good, bad, and ugly. It's allowing them to be who they are right where they are. They, in turn, get to love who they see in the mirror. How do you think that would change your child's life? if they knew that no matter what happened, they would still feel good about themselves. It's pretty pivotal. I know it because I've experienced it as an adult, let alone a child. You've experienced it too. Being able to look at yourself knowing that, you know what? I'm not a reject. I'm a rock star on any stage. And it doesn't matter whether I fail or whether I succeed. It's who I am. And that's the confidence within. The hope of our future is being built in the minds of our young. So be a courageous parent today and help your child, guide your child in these many accomplishments. Go out today, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.